do you think that science is affecting people's faith in God these days?
Yes. Science is a major, if you like, kind of challenge for all world religions. Why? Because science is somehow offering us a very rational, a very testable thesis regarding the nature of reality. It's giving us a very joined up view regarding how we deal with the world that we live in. And it's very successful, dramatically successful. So it's not only that they give the theory, but you can see, if you like, this marvelous way how this theory turns into practice. All these gizmos you have that you use, all the advances that you have, you know, you can fly, you know, from London to India in 7 hours and all that. All this fantastic innovation that came about by science automatically gives great, if you like, confidence that all of us have in science. Nothing wrong with it. My background is science, so I love science. And I see the integrity of science and how positive it has been for the greater good. There's nothing to challenge that. And again, the important thing about science is it gives you a, if you like, a joined up worldview. So if you like, if you get a scientific worldview, everything has to sit well with each other. So chemistry must sit well with biology and physics and so on. So all these kind of different ways of approaching reality sit well together. They're congruent. They are not contradictory. So it's a very self-consistent system of thinking, which is, of course, what we like. We don't like things we are disjointed and kind of at loggerheads with each other in the same system. So science is a very, if you like, very joined up system. It does a wonderful job of trying to make sense of the world that we live in, and in a way harnessing nature for our betterment. This is in fact what dharma means. Understanding the nature of reality, harnessing it for our betterment. So science is doing precisely that without the word dharma, so be it. So I have nothing but, if you like, tremendous love for science. And an important thing is this, because dharma is defined almost in the same way that science is defined, making sense of the world that we live in. There is no way Hindu religion can go against the teachings of science, against the findings of science. If science today says this is what is happening in cosmology, Hinduism can't say, oh no, we don't agree. And they don't wave a book, fortunately, saying, no, it's in my book, you can't be right. So we are open to, if you like, open to interact with the findings of science. Majority of world religions struggle. And if you are a very traditionalist Hindu, you too will struggle. But if you are an open-minded Hindu, in the sense you are prepared to look at the kind of more contemporary vision of Hinduism, you will have no difficulty with the findings of science. To the contrary, science is refreshing the message of Hinduism. I'm telling you, I'll show you some examples. In cosmology, this idea of Big Bang sits well with the esoteric Hinduism. Creation started with space, time, and causation unfolding. See, it sits very well. There's no six-day creation, all that. So in a way, it fits well with the ideas of science. Another thing that, for example, fits well with science is the complexity that is embedded in all living things shows there is more to us than, if you like, the material frame that we possess. And again, this is the finding of modern, if you like, life sciences. This is called complexification. You cannot somehow explain reality or the living being in terms of matter and its epiphenomena. So again, it sits well with Hinduism. So a lot of issues, a lot of new ideas that are coming out in science sit extremely well with Hinduism, esoteric Hinduism. Be careful. Suppose you are kind of fixated on the narrative of Hinduism, all the Purans, you are in trouble with science. Science will kick you out straight away. Suppose you say, we came out of Vishnu's belly button, science will get lost. You talk about space, time, and causation unfolding, they say, yes, this is esoteric, philosophically oriented Hinduism, rather than the Smriti or the Puranic oriented Hinduism, which is fixated on narrative. Narrative is a very useful way of conveying very subtle ideas through colorful storytelling, but that is all. It's a ploy. You must grow out of it. If you don't wish to grow out of the ploy of Purans, you are at loggerheads with science. There's no way you can win. You'll be laughed out of your university if you try to impose, this is in my Puran, written. They say, this Puran is legendary, my friend, grow up. Stop sucking your thumb. So it's a necessary requirement that the Hindus move from, if you like, the narrative part of Hinduism to the philosophic part of Hinduism. Then they will have no problem with science whatsoever.